today I wanted to talk about prayer a little bit. And I'm not the guy who brings this up. I look around on social media. I converse with friends and I hear all this stuff. We'll pray for you. Well, please pray for them. And well, you know, you got to seek out prayer. And I hear all of this. And so I'm not initiating this. I am responding to what I'm hearing almost on a daily basis in my life. I have a lot of friends who are Christians. And actually just yesterday, speaking with a friend who's a Muslim, and I have Jewish friends and people of other faiths who are prayers. And so I'm around people who think like this. And so I just wanted to address a few things. And what are they saying? When somebody prays, what are they saying? What are they asking for? What are they asking this deity? And I'm going to call the deity God. So if you call him by Jehovah or somebody else, Allah, whatever, you can kind of just superimpose that, correct the word for me there. But when you're praying to God, what's your goal? What are you going for there? And we're just using as example that Aunt Betty got into a car wreck and she's in intensive care. And so we're saying, hey, please pray for her, somebody says. What are you praying for? God is all knowing, right? Like he knows everything that's ever happened. He knows when a sparrow falls. He knows the future. He designed everything. He is in such complete control. He knows everything. And he makes way better judgment calls than mere mortals could. Like he knows who needs to die. He knows who needs to live. He knows all this stuff, right? I'm going with a he. I hope that's okay with you. If that's what he, if that's how good he is, that's what he knows, then why are you praying? What are you wanting him to do? So let's say God, obviously, he wanted Betty to be in a car wreck, or he was okay with it. Maybe he wasn't paying attention or didn't realize that she was a faithful follower, and or somehow maybe he messed up and she got into a collision and she got seriously injured and she's about to die and she's in intensive care. What is it you want God to do? Do you want God to snap his fingers and cure her? Not like he cures amputees, because that's one group he definitely doesn't cure. There's actually a website, whywon'tgodhealamputees.com. But other group, like he allegedly will cure people with a lot of other ailments. Is that what you want? You want him to make all of her shattered bones and her loss of blood and her abrased skin, all of those issues and her open head injury or brain injury. Do you want all that stuff, him to just snap his fingers? And she wakes up and says, you know, holy cow, what just happened? And then, hey, I feel great, and walk out of the hospital. Is that what you're asking for? Or are you asking for the doctors to have God guide their hand? Well, if God's going to guide their hand, why'd they go to medical school? Well, does it take a combination? Does it take a combination? Because if God can't direct the surgeon's hand, or somebody who's not a surgeon, if he can't direct my hand to sew up somebody's brain or heart, then why can't he? Why doesn't he have enough power to direct my hand to do that? If he hasn't all this power, why would a Christian person interested in healing people, helping people as a physician or a nurse or something like that, why would that person bother to go get all this training and experience? Because God's hand is going to guide him. Well, if you're thinking, well, no, he's not going to actually guide him that way. We just want the person to feel peace in their heart while they're being operated on. And we want the doctor to feel peace in her heart while she's operating. And we just want this peace in their hearts. Well, if that's what you're saying, and prayer is the way that you want to get there, and either Aunt Betty or the surgeon likes it when you say that you're praying, you know, that they'll feel peaceful, rather than them having a balanced diet, exercising, yoga, kind of taking care of their mental health. If you would rather that God take care of that rather than them have that normal habit, okay, I guess. I guess it's prayer is okay or acceptable. But that seems to me that would be about the same as an affirmation or a meditation. You know, Stuart Smalley, and you know, I'm good enough and I'm smart enough and doggone it, people like me. Well, if you're telling yourself that, those positive vibes really do make you perform better, which it seems like, you know, oftentimes they do. Yeah, I don't have a problem with that. But you got to realize, if you're thinking that way, that it's not a reasonable science-based thing. You got to accept this is a faith thing. This is a complete It's not a rational thing. It's faith. It's the opposite of faith. It's ration. It's reason that would have you want the doctor to have an education or experience or whatever. It is faith if you just want God to make somebody feel good or less stressed or guide somebody's hand or magically heal somebody. Is this making sense? Am I being too harsh? I'm kind of ripping this apart. At what point is it that somebody says, please pray for Betty? What am I missing here? Is it just to give everybody lovely feelings? How would you feel if somebody said, hey, I got the request. I love Betty's awesome. I love her. I love you. I really want the surgeon to do a great job, but I don't do the prayer thing. Can I send some positive vibes? Well, what do you think? If that person said that, do you think that sending positive vibes will do as much good? Like from a scientific standpoint, you measure her heart rate, blood pressure now, you really scientifically look at Aunt Betty and you look at the surgeon's performance, have another team that's observing that says, okay, he did this right, did that wrong. Is that what you're talking about? Or are you just talking about kind of this, I don't know, this thing that's floating around that maybe people feel better and perform a little better. And then if it doesn't work out, is that God? Did God choose to follow through? No, I was actually right in the first place. When I got her into that wreck, I did want her to die and suffer, a few days beforehand from the burns and the abrasions and such. And I do want her to die, and I'm gonna go ahead and have her die. Well, then you say, well, that was God's will. Well, if you're going to say it was God's will, my faithful friends, then why would you mess with God's will? Aren't you just some little piddly human that can't understand his ways? Why would you interfere with such incredible know-it-all-ness that God has? Am I being harsh here? Am I missing something? If I am, please respond rationally. If you want to respond with, you just haven't felt God's love touch your heart. Okay, whatever, you can respond that way. But like, if you have a real, intelligent, reasonable, rational thing to say, then maybe I'm missing the purpose of prayer. Because as I've just described it, I don't see much purpose in it at all.